origin of the life, how the life has been originated, how the earth has come into existence. This is very important questions, and we will see that whether it has something to do with the viruses or not. Whether those were the viruses which were first of all has come onto earth and then the life has come, or whether it is the life which has originated first. So we see in detail. Earth is the scientific problem which is not yet solved. There are a large number of theories which need to be considered when we are talking about the earth. There are plenty of the theories, there are plenty of the ideas, there are plenty of the things, but still we are not came into any conclusion. There are different scientists which are talking differently about the earth, that how the earth has been originated. Most of you have already studied or already heard about the Big Bang theory. This is one of the theories. You have listened about the black hole. So there are a large number of theories which need to be discussed, and we need to be conclusion that how the earth has originated. There is large number of money has been spent on this idea, and we are still now clear facts that how the earth has been originated. However, it is generally agreed that we have the common ancestors. Most of us agree on this, that it is generally agreed that all life today evolved by the common descent from a single and primitive life forms. Okay, then when it has been originated, we are still not clear. However, again, guess, it is estimated that life took place perhaps 4,000 million years ago. Then the origin of the life, whether it is the RNA who came first, we will just try how the oxidization occurs, how the RNA was periodically happened. So here we can see, and we can see and try that how the life has been originated. Need more prebiotic chemistry. If the RNA were the first who were originated, then you can see here, or the need to make the RNA prebiotically. How is it possible? How it happens? Different sets of the problems are there, and then need oxidized minerals or the deserts, which is also again not possible present on the earth. We are all Marians, and then need more prebiotic chemistry or the alternative chemistries. Then the spontaneous generation. Until the 19th century, many people believed that regular spontaneous generation of the life happened from the non-living matter. This was called the spontaneous generation and was disproved. However, the Louis Pasteur, who is the very big scientist, he believed, disproved, and he said that it is not possible because of the spores. No bacteria and viruses grew on the sterile materials. Here again we see that viruses, and how the viruses can come, how the earth and origin has been come. RNA in the protocells, whether the viruses came, or the DNA in the protocells, it came originated to the viruses, or the bacteria, archae, and the eukarya, they give rise to the viruses, and then or the maybe it is the specific the viruses or the protocells came to the DNA, and then DNA towards the bacteria, or the DNA in the archae, and then they give to the viruses. So these are all the theories about the origin of the life. After that, one of the Darwin's theory is very important and very famous. Most of you have studied about the Darwin theories in your FSC classes. In a letter of the Joseph Dalton Hooker on the 11th February 1871, Charles Darwin proposed a natural process of the origin of the life. He suggests that original spark of life may have begun in the warm little pond, and all sorts of the possible things which needed for the life were already present in that little pond. These were considered of the ammonia, there were present the phosphoric salts, there were present the lights, heat, electricity, all the necessary things which are needed for the life were present there, and this little pond have given rise to the life. However, this theory seems very strange in the present environment, but the Darwin explains that at present day such matter would be instantly maybe absorbed which was produced at the time of the origin of life, but it would not have the case before the living creatures were formed, and in this case when the living creatures are there, this is not the case, and we still can believe that this can happen like this. According to Darwin, the protein complex was chemically formed because of those mixture because of those necessary things which become readily, and it will undergo the complex changes, and then that protein has become more and more complex after the life has continued. After the Darwin, it was about 1871 and 1924, there was no much progress was done. However, until the Haldane and Oparin, they were doing their experiments, and Alexander Oparin claimed that atmospheric oxygen prevented the synthesis of the organic molecules. Organic molecules are necessary building blocks for the evolution of the life.